Good morning. So my background probably looks different because I'm in a cruise ship cabin, and I had some people ask, what do I bring with me when I go on a cruise or on a vacation? Because obviously I can't bring all of my skincare. I only brought one suitcase and a carry-on. My carry-on just had like my little makeup bag, my computer, my husband's computer, my camera, and you know, some things so I could still film. And then my main suitcase just had some clothes, not a whole lot, three pair of shoes, and then of course a ton of skincare. So I thought, you know what, let me just show you some of the things that I bring with me on my cruise. I won't show you everything because a lot of the things I brought, I'm testing some new skincare items. For example, this new kit from Skin Medica, I don't have results on it yet. I'm just now going to start testing it while I'm on my vacation. Leah had sent this to me from Skin Beautiful RX, so I'm not gonna share some of the extra things that I threw in, that I tried to push in and make room in my suitcase. I won't share, you know, all of those little extra things that I am starting to test out, but I wanted to share with you, what do I bring when we go on these long trips so that you can see kind of what different products I like to bring and then how much I like to bring. If you want to just jump to the products in my travel bag, my big travel bag of skincare, to see what products I actually did bring on this cruise, I'll leave the timestamp if you just want to jump there. But for those of you who might be interested, wondering what ship I'm on, why I'm traveling and all that good stuff, I'll just quickly share a little bit about my personal life. But if you're not interested, totally get it. Just fast forward if you just want to see the skincare. We actually slept in this morning. We slept until like 10 o'clock. I think it's around 11 o'clock. My husband, he just went and got me a coffee. That's one thing I will say. He always gets up, gets dressed, and he goes and he picks me up a coffee and he brings it back to the room because he knows that I take 800 years to get ready. Not even on days that I'm not even, you know, doing my hair or makeup, he knows I still take forever because I like to, you know, lollygag, sip my coffee and slowly get ready. Today is a sea day on the cruise ship. So what that means is we are just basically not doing any stops today. We are just traveling at sea all day long. And then tomorrow is also a sea day all day long. So I figured I will take advantage of these relaxing days. And while I unpack, I will just share some videos with you guys. So many of you already know that my husband and I, he retired from the fire department. He was a captain with the Broward Sheriff's Department. We decided to sell everything. We had some properties, so we sold everything. I was in real estate. I still have my license, but I don't take on new clients. I even sold my car. We decided to pretty much just be homeless, but live in hotels or cruise ships or wherever we decide to go, whether it be in the United States or in different countries. We frequently go to Punta del Este in Uruguay. That's in South America near Argentina, for those of you who don't know where Uruguay is. And we were just there recently and we lived there for, golly, 4.5, almost 5 months, I think. And we will every now and then go to Texas because that's where my husband's mom lives. She did go to South America with us and we just rented a big apartment. But she lives in Texas, in San Antonio, so we will go there every now and then, and we just stay in a hotel when we're there, and we'll go there, help her out, and, you know, of course, spend time with her. She used to cruise with us often, but she's 90 years old, almost 91 years old, and she's just physically not really able to, and it starts to get difficult for us pushing her in a wheelchair. She can walk, but, you know, it gets difficult. Those of you with older parents, you know what I'm talking about. So she just doesn't really enjoy cruising the way she used to. Plus, we're probably kind of boring because she just loves to shop, like shop nonstop. Even if she's looking at the same thing every single day, she loves it. And I actually don't like to shop. Some of you might be like, what do you mean you don't like to shop? You love makeup and skincare. I like to shop online for makeup and skincare, but like clothes, shoes, I am so not into any of that at all. Shopping to me is not an exciting thing. So I think we're probably just too boring, you know, for her, so she doesn't enjoy going on vacations with us too much. So, you know, it gets expensive staying in a hotel when we're visiting her. If we're traveling in the USA in different places, it also gets expensive no matter where we are staying in a hotel. So since we've been cruising for many years, we are at a, you know, a little bit higher status with Royal Caribbean. We're Diamond Plus. We might get to Pinnacle, the highest level, but that would probably take us another year to get there. If you are an avid cruiser like we are, you will know that oftentimes there are some really great deals on cruise ships. So what we always do when we cruise is we look for the really good deals. One that we just did a month ago, I think came out to be $32 a day. You know, that's cheaper than staying in a hotel. We were just in a hotel in San Antonio. It's like 100 something a night. And then you gotta add up, you know, food and all of that. But when you're on a cruise ship, the food is included in the price that you pay. Now, it came out to be like $35 or $32 a night per person, but then you do have to pay your taxes and your port fees. But it still ends up, you know, for us being a lot cheaper than being in a hotel. And we love to cruise. We could care less if we're even stopping anywhere. We just enjoy being on a cruise ship and sitting outside and, you know, reading a book or going to the solarium and just relaxing. It's very relaxing for us. And of course we love the food as well. And what we ended up doing is we booked back to back to back. We booked a few of them, so we're gonna stay on the same ship for a few weeks, actually for like 5 weeks, because like I said, it ended up turning out to be less expensive than staying in a hotel. And you know, when we go to hotels, we're not bougie people. We don't stay in the super expensive hotels. Sometimes we, you know, try to see how cheap we can get the hotel without putting our lives in jeopardy. So, but normally we try to just stay in, you know, an average, fairly affordable hotel, because you're only sleeping there. So we're not really looking for all those fancy amenities in a hotel. And the other thing is, you know, we do a lot of traveling and things like that, but we're actually very, very frugal. We try to stretch our dollar as much as we can so that we can continue to live this lifestyle and go on multiple vacations. And even when we're traveling in different countries, we're not like spending our life savings. We really budget things out. We plan things in advance and we try to make our vacations very cost effective. So keep in mind, I don't have a mortgage. I don't have home insurance. I don't have property taxes. I don't have an electric bill. I don't have a cable bill. I don't have an internet bill. I don't have any of those expenses. I have zero bills. I even sold my car. We just kept one of our cars. That's how we are living the lifestyle traveling, but it's not like traveling like the rich and famous. And if you know me, you will know there are things that I will spend money on. Of course, you know, I do like some pricier skincare products, but when it comes to things like clothes, shoes, things like that, you know, I shop at Marshall's. I could care less if it was two seasons ago, you know, in style two seasons ago. None of that. I'm not into all of that fashion and style and all of that. I want what's comfortable. Every now and then I will dress up. Since we're traveling, I can't have an outfit that only this one pair of shoes goes with that outfit, and then you have to have all the specific jewelry for that outfit. I have to bring pieces that, you know, I can wear the pants one day and then maybe put a different blouse or a t-shirt on with it another day, or throw on my tennis shoes or flip-flops. I have to wear and use things that, you know, will really fit in this one suitcase that we travel with. Just so you know, when you do go on a cruise, you are allowed to bring more than one suitcase, but we don't want to, because first of all, it's a hassle toting around, you know, all of those suitcases when you're going from each stop. So we try to just make it easier and each of us just bring that one suitcase. And we're about to go to, we're actually gonna go to Israel. Hopefully, we've already paid for everything. Hopefully we can still get in, but we're gonna be going to Israel, I don't know, in like 6 months. And I really have to figure out how to downsize my suitcase, because after we're cruising over there, after we get there, we wanna travel all around, you know, the Holy Land. We wanna do Petra, we wanna go to Egypt, all those different places. And it's very difficult traveling with a huge suitcase to all of those stops. That's gonna be kind of a fun challenge for me. I've already started doing my little shopping for that trip of things that I can put in even in a smaller suitcase for that trip. So I will take you guys along with me on those trips if you're interested. And I don't put everything here on YouTube. Every now and then I will post more personal things, different travel things on my Instagram. So if you want to follow me on Instagram, I would love to have you there as well. Also, another question every now and then does pop up, which I guess it's kind of weird to ask somebody that, but I get it. I wonder these things too. People will say, how can you even afford to do all of this? Like I said, we don't have mortgage, we don't have property taxes, we don't have any. Think of all the bills that you pay every month for your house, for your car, and not just the house payment. Think of, you know, your electric bill, and you know, maybe you want to go buy a new microwave or you want to decorate. We don't have any of those expenses. Also, I've never had children, so I'm sure those of you that have children know how expensive children are. And again, we save. My husband, he was a bigger saver, of course, than me. When I met him, it was funny, my girlfriend said, you know, firefighters, they don't make a whole lot of money. And I said, well, I don't care. I'm not with him for money. You know, I make my own money. I was in real estate. But little did I know, he had already been saving for 30 some years. So he already was set up and ready to retire when, pretty much when I met him. My husband is just now 59 years old. He'll be 60 in December. And, you know, he's already been retired for what, three years. I used to spend a little bit not responsibly when in my younger years, but of course now that I've gotten older and I want to be able to, you know, live this lifestyle and travel, I really make sure that I don't just go and, you know, blow money on silly things. And then one huge question that people have asked me is, well, don't you miss your stuff? And, you know, don't you get annoyed living out of a suitcase? I don't really have stuff. I've never really been into a bunch of stuff. So when we sold our properties, we gave most everything away. I am a giver. That's one thing I do. I give, 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 give. You know, every time you see me with a new robe on, like in many of my videos that I do, I buy a lot of my clothes off Amazon because I love them. But I know I can't keep all of those clothes. So there's a housekeeper that I love in the hotel that we always stay at. So I always give her a lot of those clothes and she absolutely loves them. And then when we had our homes, you know, we could have sold a lot of the furniture and things like that, but I always would rather, you know, I feel like versus me just making that money, I'd rather bless someone else, especially if I know that they need it. So there were some people in the area we found and, you know, they had children. We gave them a ton of stuff. So we do have a little storage space in Florida. It's very small. It's like the size of a small bedroom. And we did keep my mattress because I have a special, like a Tempur-Pedic mattress, but it's one of the only ones that are perfect for my back. And we only kept a few things, you know, family photos and things that meant something to us. But for the most part, we gave away pretty much everything else. So we don't have stuff. And like I said, I just give stuff away all the time. I have my little set amount of clothes that I keep for winter months, a little bit for the summer, but I don't keep accumulating more stuff because as I do that, I have to keep giving more stuff away. So no, I don't really miss my stuff because I've never been someone that would get attached to stuff. I definitely never got attached to homes. One of my real estate brokers, when he said this to me, it always stuck. I used to call my house my house, and he would say, stop calling it that, call it a property, because he said, if you want to make money in real estate, you're going to be selling that place that you're living in, and the next place that you buy, you're going to be selling and making money. But if you keep calling it your home, you feel that kind of attachment to it and you won't want to get rid of it. A lot of times people get so attached to their home and they never want to sell it, even if they could make a ton of money and then buy something else and make a ton more money. You know, when we get attached to stuff, you know, worldly possessions, things that really don't, you know, matter, it's difficult to get rid of it. So for me, none of my stuff even matters. It's just stuff. You know, I can't take it to heaven with me. It's just stuff. So I try to do whatever I can do to make that dollar stretch so that we can live this lifestyle. And again, it's not a fancy bougie lifestyle. I'll show you this cruise ship cabin probably in another video. And because, you know, the beds aren't made or anything. So I'll wait until we check into our new room and I'll film it to show you what it looks like when you come in. It's extremely small, but we love that. We have no windows. We've never even gotten a balcony room on a cruise ship because you're only in the room to sleep. And we love it when the room is pitch black. So that's another thing that we do to save money on cruise ships. But I could do a whole other video on different things that are included on cruise ships that aren't included and what we do to save even more money when we're on a ship. All right, so I am going to turn this camera around. I just have a little like suction cup thing. I have it stuck on the mirror. I don't have a ring light. I did bring a little teeny one, but I'm not even using it. I'm just using the vanity lights that they have here on this little vanity. And then I will go through this kind of travel bag that I put my skincare and hair care and things like that in. And for this video, I will only show you the skincare. I'm not gonna show you all the hair care because it's already super long as it is. I'm just gonna show you what I absolutely have to bring on a ship with me that I don't like to be without. Okay, I have everything set up, but something just kind of fun. Leave a comment down below. Can anyone guess how many sunscreens they think I brought with me for, I guess we're gonna be gone about 7 weeks total because we have some other traveling that we're doing. How many sunscreens do you think I brought? Now remember, I am a sunscreen fanatic, and since I have that hyperpigmentation, that's melasma, I go through sunscreens really quickly, but I also like to have a variety of sunscreens because you never know what kind of mood I'm gonna be in or what my skin's doing for that day. So just for fun, leave a comment down below before you watch this and tell me how many sunscreens that you think that I packed with me. So this is one that I keep in my purse. This is by Neutrogena. Regina. This is fabulous if you're going on a vacation. It looks like a deodorant, but you can just quickly wipe it on your skin. I do this for super quick touch-ups. You can get this really inexpensive at the drugstore. This is also another sunscreen I brought to keep in, you know, the beach bag or in my purse. It looks like a little mini deodorant. This is one of my absolute favorites. It's by Aven. If you guys are looking for a quick, easy way to touch up your sunscreen throughout the day and you don't want to deal with reapplying the actual lotion that you put on, this is a compact. This provides an all mineral SPF 50 protection, and I'm able to just put this on right over top of my makeup. I use this, you know, every couple hours. This is what I'm touching up my face with. And then I use, of course, those sticks for my neck, my arms, my hands, chest, things like that. I never leave home without this. I have one in my makeup bag. I keep one in my purse. This is by Color Science. This is what I use underneath my eyes. It's like a concealer. It's a brightener, but it's an all mineral SPF 35 sunscreen. And then I recently got this one a few months ago. This is, let's get this to focus. This is by the brand Jane Iredale. I do really like this one, but I don't like it better than my Color Science. And that's what I was testing it out to see if I like this one better or this one better, because this is less expensive, but I do like this one better. This one's more hydrating. It's a little bit creamier. This one has more coverage though. I brought three from Color Science. These are almost empty. That's another reason I brought them, because I'm trying to use them up, but you know, I didn't want them to go to waste while I was gone. These are two of my favorites. This is the Color Science Flex. This is one of my all-time favorites from Color Science. This is their Color Science Glow. You know, they have that really expensive product by Charlotte Tilbury that, you know, gives you that nice glow. I can't even think of the name of it, but I've owned it before and it's nice. But honestly, I feel like this is a dupe for it. And of course, this is an all mineral SPF 50. So if you're looking for a product that's going to give you a beautiful radiance and glow underneath your foundation, this is an amazing product for that. And you're getting your all mineral SPF 50 protection as well as that beautiful glow. I also always bring this. I brought two of these, one in my makeup bag. I keep one in my purse. This is something else I use midday to touch up. This is by Color Science. This is their Brush On powder. It's an SPF 50. Brought this one by Aven. I actually brought their non-tinted, but it's in the bathroom. So let's add that as another one. This one that's tinted, if you have a darker complexion, look how dark this is. I'll just show you on my hand really quickly. This is perfect for me because it just blends in really nicely. Sometimes it's a little bit too dark, but do you see how dark this tint is? And I'm like a medium tan. I have a lot of yellow in my skin, but if you have a darker skin tone than me, I think you will love this. This is another one I really love. This is my second one. This is one that I saw an Indian doctor recommend for skin with melasma, so I bought it. It's really expensive, but I do really like it. I don't know, I think it's like $60 or something for this little sunscreen, and if you go through sunscreen the way I do, that's just a lot of money for sunscreen, but I do really like it. This is by the brand Mezzo Aesthetic, and this also has a nice kind of dark tint to it. I brought this one by Super Goop. This is their matte screen SPF 40. I tried this a couple years ago or whenever it first came out, and I hated it because it has a lot of that silicone feel in it, and I thought there's no way this is matte. It just felt slimy on my hand, but I never gave it a try. So a while back I tried it again and I actually let it sit and I loved the dry down. It's not like a dry matte, but it actually makes like a beautiful primer for your makeup. Now my all-time favorite. This is probably my fifth tube. This is fabulous for a face primer. If you're looking for a mattifying face primer, this is by the brand Panoxyl. You can just pick it up in the drugstore. I always just grab it on Amazon. And this is their AM oil-free moisturizer, but it has an SPF 30 all mineral sunscreen in it. If you are looking for a mattifying primer, if you're gonna wear makeup, because this does have a slight white tint to it, not much at all, I can blend it in, but there is a slight cast, but this is my all-time favorite holy grail that I use underneath my foundation, because this will help my foundation to stay put all day. This will keep the oil away. It doesn't dry out my skin, so if you have more normal skin, it's never dried my skin out, but it just prevents that breakthrough oil. So maybe you have a teenager or someone that you know, has oily skin, they might like this. This is just like a hidden drugstore gem that I hope they never stop making it, because it is absolutely fabulous. If you've watched any of my sunscreen videos, you'll know this is my all-time favorite sunscreen ever. It's an SPF 32. This is by the brand Skin Medica. This is fabulous if you have irritated skin from retin-A or anything like that. A lot of doctors will recommend this sunscreen for like post procedures and different things if your skin is sensitive or irritated. The only thing I don't like about it, even though it's my all-time favorite, it's only an SPF 32. I'd rather it be a little bit higher, but it's fine because I just reapply my sunscreen constantly anyways. But this is a tinted sunscreen. This is a very sheer tint, a much lighter tint than the other ones. But if you're looking for a very elegant sunscreen that doesn't feel like you have sunscreen on, this is a fabulous sunscreen. I do have a little discount code for this. I'll link everything I'm sharing down below. This is my other all-time favorite sunscreen by the brand Dermatology. It's definitely no secret for those of you that have watched my channel forever. This one is the non-tinted one. I didn't bring the tinted one. I only brought the non-tinted one. This one's also one of my husband's favorites. But if you want more details on this sunscreen, I probably have 80 million videos sharing how much I love this sunscreen. It's affordable. It is a very effective, high protection sunscreen. It's an SPF, this is a SPF 45, and their tinted one has a little bit higher SPF because it has the iron oxides in it. But for me, I love them both. They work great on all skin types, normal, dry, oily skin. It never breaks me out, and it's affordable. And I have a really good discount code for this brand as well. And then one other sunscreen I haven't talked about here on my channel, but I have recommended it to many of you guys who are saying, oh my gosh, I hate sunscreen. I want something that doesn't feel like I have sunscreen on. This is by the brand Beauty of Joseon or Joseon. But if you want a sunscreen that doesn't even feel like it's sunscreen, if you are one of those, if you hate sunscreen, but you know you need to wear it and you don't mind using a chemical sunscreen, this never burns my skin. I even put this all over my eyes. This is probably my fifth tube because this is so travel friendly. It's just like a little mini toothpaste tube. I will link all these down below, and just for fun, I will pop up on the screen how many sunscreens I actually brought with me, and we'll see who got it right. Now let's jump into cleansers. This is my all-time favorite Holy Grail cleansing oil. In the evening, I always do a double cleanse, meaning I wash my face twice, or I will use an oil or a balm first to emulsify my makeup and sunscreen, my mascara, and then I will follow up with whatever gentle face cleanser afterwards. So I brought my DHC deep cleansing oil. This one was half full, so I knew I would probably use up most of it while we were on this trip. Another one I brought that I absolutely love, this is by Avène. This is a very, it's just like a very sheer lotion type cleanser. I will often just use this as my first and my second cleanse, or I will use this as my first cleanse. It takes off all of my makeup, sunscreen, mascara. This is perfect if you have sensitive skin. This one's fragrance free, it's super gentle, but this is really powerful because it will take everything off. I've never had a mascara that this doesn't emulsify. And then of course I brought my CeraVe foaming face cleanser. This travel size will last me well over a month, so this is all I brought for an actual face cleanser because I figure if I run out, I could just grab whatever they have downstairs on the cruise ship. If I get a breakout, I brought this little Neutrogena Stubborn Acne. You just dip a little Q-tip in it. It'll just kind of dry up a pimple. So I always keep this with me. I rarely use this though. But what I do use if I get a breakout, I love these little acne spot dots. They come with 60 dots, but they're not all those big round dots. Some other brands, they just come with the same size dot. And you know, sometimes if you get a teeny little pimple, you want an itty bitty little circle dot. And these are just like that medical grade hydrocolloid patch. So it just basically kind of suffocates the pimple. It'll bring it to the surface. And it also prevents you from picking at it if you, you know, feel something on your face and you have a habit of picking. So I always, always have these. Let's do serums. I wasn't able to put this in a travel size. This is by Skin Medica, my all-time favorite. It is their TNS Advanced Serum. I used to love their original, but they stopped making that one, and that the old one had fragrance. This is fragrance-free. This has even more growth factors in it. This is, for me, I can use this one time and I see a change in my skin. I absolutely love it, but they've done, you know, all kinds of studies and stuff, and apparently I think they say that you look 6 years younger after 2 weeks of using this. It is an expensive product. This is not a cheap product at all, but for me, it is totally worth it. I do have a discount code for this, but you know, it's still expensive. But if you are over maybe 35, 40, if you are looking for something to really take your skincare to that next level, if you're looking for growth factors that will help regenerate your cells and really make a difference in anti-aging in your skin, again, it's a pricey product, but boy, does this work. And as you can tell, I am not willing to leave home without it. I love it that much. Another serum I brought, this is one, I actually have the smaller, ounces, but this is the bigger ounces, but the bottle is like thinner and smaller, so I brought it. Now, I didn't pay for this. Leah at Skin Beautiful RX, she sent this one to me. I haven't opened this one yet, but this is the newest Revision Skincare DEJ Daily Boosting Serum. I do have a discount code for this as well, but you guys, this stuff is fabulous. If you don't want to use an actual growth factor serum, but you want something that's gonna give you fairly similar results, I don't think I've seen anything else on the market like this. Another serum that has become one of my all-time favorite serums. This is by the brand Dermalect. This is their Self-Esteem Beauty Sleep Serum. If you are looking for the most amazing exfoliating serum, but not one that's going to cause burning and, you know, have your face fall off, I have a couple videos on why this is so amazing. And when I say this is a beauty sleep serum, you literally wake up and you can't stop staring at your skin. This has a combination of acids. It's already formulated, so you don't have to try to figure out what acids to layer. So it has vitamin C in it. It has an acid that's going to go deep in your pores and make your pores super small and tight. And then it also has another acid that will exfoliate any of those little, you know, flakies or dryness or dullness on the surface. This is also quite affordable compared to so many other skincare products on the market. My skin will constantly stay looking smooth and glowy just from this one little serum. And I can do the easiest skincare routine with this also. I can cleanse my face, put this on, put on my moisturizer, and go to bed. I don't have to do 20 different steps. But I'll link every product that I'm sharing down below. And then I will also, if I have any videos specific to these, if you're interested in more information, I will link those videos down below as well. I brought two retinols with me. This is my favorite. This has become a favorite in just like 3 months. This is by the brand Medic 8. This is their Crystal Retinol, not retinol with an OL, it's with retinol. It's a retinaldehyde, so it's a lot more gentle on the skin, but it really packs a punch and you see really fast anti-aging with this. This is the Crystal Retinol 10. I've already used their Crystal Retinol 3. They have a 6, and those are just lower strengths. This is the 10, which I love. Probably for my skin, I love this the best. But I also, during their Black Friday sale, I bought their newest one, their Crystal Retinol 20, and I've only used that a couple times. They say you need to go through 2 or 3 tubes of this to get your skin used to it before you jump to the 20. This is my favorite daily retinol. This is fabulous. And then, of course, this is my holy grail retinol. This is an actual retinol, OL. However, this is a 5% strength retinol. This is by the brand Truth Treatment Systems. This is their 5%, their newest retinol serum. This is meant to be used as a treatment. So if you already use a different retinol like I do, or say you use prescription strength retin A, a lot of people will just use this as a really potent retinol treatment a couple times a week, but definitely cannot leave home without this. I'll share with you the vitamin C serums I brought. This is one of my all-time favorites from Revision Skincare. This is their C+ Correcting Complex 30%. This is not an irritating form of vitamin C. This one does not have L-ascorbic acid, which can be irritating on many people. This one has the THD, the tetrahexyldecyl ascorbate, in it, and this is supposed to penetrate a little bit deeper, but if vitamin C serums cause you irritation, look for one with this ingredient in it. This one's a pricey product. Again, I have a discount code for many of these, but not everything. But just if this is out of your budget, just look for another vitamin C that has the THD in it, and that is a lot more gentle, doesn't cause the irritation, but it really packs a punch on the skin. And this one is a very high strength. Also, really quickly, this 5% retinol that I just shared, this has a super high strength of the THD vitamin C. Actually, I think this retinol treatment has a higher strength vitamin C in it of the non-irritating form, a higher strength than even this one does. If you have not tried anything from the brand Truth Treatments, you'll love probably just about everything. Everything they have is very minimal ingredients, but very potent and really makes a difference in the skin. But of course, you know, it's an expensive brand. But if you're looking to kind of just downsize and just have a couple products versus spending on a ton of different products, it might not be as expensive if you stop buying a bunch of other products that, you know, maybe aren't even doing anything for your skin. But this one, you'll see results the very next morning when you wake up using something like this. This is one that I really like. This is by the brand Obagi, but this is a 20% L-ascorbic vitamin C serum. And if I use this every day, my face will start to get irritated. But I do really enjoy the results I get with L-ascorbic acid, but like I said, I just can't use it daily. And this is one that is formulated so nicely. This one does have some fragrance in it, so if you hate that, you know, funky hot dog smell that most L-ascorbic C serums give, this one actually has a nice light fragrance. You don't smell anything hot doggy at all, and this is super potent. I do have a discount code for this as well, but I use this maybe 2 to 3 times a week because from what I read, L-ascorbic acid can kind of stay in the skin for up to 72 hours. So I feel like why use this daily if it's going to cause irritation if I use it too much? I still can get the benefits by using it 2 days a week. And by doing so, I'm using a super powerful vitamin C serum, but I'm not getting any irritation when I do that. And another vitamin C serum I brought with me, one of my all-time favorites. This is by the brand Urban Skin RX. This is not just an L-ascorbic vitamin C serum. It's a lower dose, a 10% L-ascorbic, so it doesn't irritate my skin. But it also is chock full of a bunch of really good ingredients if you're battling with hyperpigmentation or melasma. And then I also brought a prescription. This is my azelaic acid 15%. You don't have to get a prescription if you want to use azelaic acid. Paula's Choice has a really nice one that's a 10%, and I can link that down below. That's the one I've used for years. This one I think is still expensive, even with my insurance, even with the copay. I think I still had to pay like $60-$70 for it, but I got this prescribed from the dermatologist. I asked her for it because I love azelaic acid. It's great if you have rosacea, if you have redness in your skin, if you have irritated skin, if you have hyperpigmentation, if you have acne. I mean, azelaic acid can be used by most everyone. And since I have hyperpigmentation and melasma, I do oftentimes like to layer a few serums. And this is one, I don't love a lot of products from The Ordinary. There's just a few products I do like from them, but this is their hyaluronic acid with 2% alpha arbutin. And the alpha arbutin is what I like in this because alpha arbutin is great to help block that excess pigment. So if you only use this by itself, for me, I do not see any results. But when I layer different types of pigment reducing ingredients together, then I do see some good results. So this is just one, you know, if I'm looking to hydrate my skin, but also have that little added bonus of the alpha arbutin, I reach for this. I also brought a little travel size of my Paula's Choice 2% BHA. This is something I've used, golly, 20, 25 years now. This is just a type of acid that will go deep down inside the pore that will help exfoliate the pore. So that's why I don't have like big, you know, blackheads or deep stretched out pores, because for 20 some years I have used products that will help keep my pores cleared out. So in turn, it will make them look even smaller. I brought a face mist. This is by the brand Replenix. This is nice, you know, right before you put on your moisturizer, or if you're trying to set your makeup, or if you just need that little pick me up midday and your face feels dry and dehydrated. I love using hydrating products. A lot of people say, oh, my skin is so dry. Well, maybe your skin's not dry. It might just be super duper dehydrated. I always like to hydrate, add that water with all of those really good ingredients before I put on any type of moisturizer. So this is one that I really enjoy, and it has this nice light scent to it. I also brought my Aven Thermal Spring Water Spray. Of course, I never leave home without this. This is like probably my all-time favorite hydrating face spray that is perfect for any skin types. I especially love this. How I discovered this was, I don't know, 10 years ago. 5 years ago when I was using my prescription strength retin-A, and it would just cause so much irritation. I've used prescription strength retin-A for over 20 some years, but sometimes just out of the blue, it would cause really bad irritation, red, flaky skin, and this is what saved my skin. This is so refreshing. It feels, you know, amazing on the skin, but it helps to heal the skin, especially if it's all red and inflamed and irritated. So I never leave home without just at least a mini can of this. While I'm sharing my products from Aven that I love, I'll just show you really quickly. I also brought one of their eye creams. This is their Physio Lift. This has a retinal in it, a retinaldehyde. I do really like this. I bought like a kit with a bunch of stuff in it, and these are some of the products I really like. These are two products I also brought from Aven. If you go on a beach vacation or a tropical vacation, I would always bring something like this, because if somebody ends up getting a sunburn, these are two products that will really help heal it instantly. In fact, I was even reading some reviews. I forget which one. I think it was this product right here, but people were saying their kid had, you know, some type of irritation, redness on their skin. They put this on and it was gone overnight. And this was after trying a ton of different products that the doctors kept recommending and nothing was working. But Avène just has some really great skincare products. I also brought my City Lips. I keep the clear one in my skincare bag. Of course, I brought three or four other ones in their shimmer shade. City Lips is not just a lip gloss. It also plumps my lips really beautifully, but I love it because it's a beautiful lip treatment with great ingredients in it. I brought a deluxe travel size of one of my favorite face mist. This is by the brand Sioris. This is their Falling Into the Rose face mist. It has this thin layer of a bunch of beautiful oils, non-pore clogging oils at the top, and then all of the hydrating ingredients and antioxidants are down here, and you just shake it up before you spray it on. But this leaves your skin so beautiful and glowy. I love this on its own, midday, as a makeup setting spray. I love it before I do moisturizer. So I have already gone through a few of these, but I got the travel size so I could take this with me. I also bought like this kit with empty travel containers so I could put products in. I brought in this container, I had some of my Dermalect, the neck cream that goes along with this product. If you have crepey, saggy skin on your neck, if you use the combination of these two, oh my gosh, my neck looks so much better now after using this neck cream with this serum on my neck. But this Dermalect neck cream, it's getting pretty close up there with my all-time favorite from City Beauty, their Invisicrate body balm, but I use the body balm on my neck. And I just put the creams in these little containers, so I just use a small amount. I also brought, I had a little bit of my Youth to the People. You can see it on here. It's a like a clay face mask. I put a little bit of that in here. For moisturizers, I brought, of course, my Vanna cream, probably my all-time favorite face moisturizer, and it's super affordable. And then I also brought my COSRX. I had this deluxe travel size of their Snail 92 All-in-One Cream. I love this. If you have super dry skin, I don't know if you're gonna like this, but if you have more normal to oily skin, this is fabulous as your moisturizer and as a treatment product. If you have dry skin, I would use this first so that you can get the brightening benefits and then put whatever moisturizer you like over top. I also had a little bit left of a travel size of my Strivectin neck cream. I do really like this. It's nice and firming, but I definitely like my new Dermalect neck cream a lot better. And then I brought four eye creams. I might have one other one that I put in my makeup bag, but I'm really loving a lot of my Korean skincare that I have. But this is just a little sample I bought. This is their black tea eye cream, and then this is one I've already ordered a second tube of. This is super affordable. I think I paid like $6 for this. This is by the brand The Plant Base. This is their peptide. It's an eye cream and it's got honey peptides. It's a lot, very hydrating and moisturizing, but it doesn't leave a film. And you know, this big tube, when you get one that's this inexpensive, I can really pile a lot on, so I really like this. And then two others that I absolutely love. I'll do a video on this brand, MediPeel, eventually. I have quite a few of their products. I'm still testing some of their other products, so I will wait to share it until I'm done testing some of their other products. But this is one of their eye creams. This is a beautiful, beautiful eye cream, but I will talk more in detail about why I love this and I'm loving this brand in another video. And then another eye cream, I've already bought a backup of this, but I kept my backup stuff in a suitcase at my mother-in-law's. And this is also by the brand Beauty of Joseon, the same brand of that sunscreen I shared with you. But this is one of their retinal eye serums. So you could put this on first and then put your eye cream over top. Sometimes I just use this, but it's not a retinol with an OL. It's not irritating. It's a retinaldehyde, so I can use this AM and PM. All right, they're already making announcements for things going on today. You might be able to hear them out in the hallway. I will end this video here. It was already super long. If you want to see another video, since I shared this product and you want to know more about it, why I think it is absolutely phenomenal, I'm going to pop a video up here, one I recently did, sharing all of the details about this product. If this is something that you're interested in, you can just look up here and click on it here. Thanks so much for watching, and I will see you in the next video.